Adobe Creative Cloud plugins and integrations.
Every creative has to deal with the complexity that is metadata. Sometimes it's just adding keywords, other times it's more complex because your customer has asked you to apply specific metadata properties to your assets as you're moving them to their asset management system. And then the asset manager might want to add custom metadata. This can be really hard to do inside of creative applications. And that's why we've built the custom metadata panel. The custom metadata panel lives inside of Bridge, Photoshop, and Illustrator, and you get it from the marketplace. And in the marketplace, once you grab it, you see it in extensions. Here it is in Bridge. It'll be in the same place in Photoshop and in Illustrator. In the Bridge, you can see there's a metadata panel. If you select an asset, it will populate with some metadata, and that's great. But this panel is often hard to scroll around to try and find the thing you want because you have to kind of take it all in at once. What we've done is we've made it possible for you to pick the very important properties for the job you're doing and make them available inside of one panel. So what we've got at the top of this is a few key IPTC and Dublin Core properties like description, creator, and so on. And then as you move down, we've got this whole section for pet shop. This is completely custom, and we've made a fictitious pet shop, and we've put in some metadata there. Keywords is the Dublin Core keywords, but then you scroll down, well, this pet type, that's a drop down. You can't do that in the Bridge, but you can here. Pick a dog, let's change it to a cat. Now you can see it lights up green, and maybe I want to pick a breed. Ah, so I've got cat breeds there. That's nice. But what if I switch it back to dog? Does that do anything? Oh, it sure does, because now we've got dog breeds. And so you can build a metadata panel that's got these nice dependencies in it and interfaces that really help the creative to focus on the important properties. We include a number of form types, including, you saw the drop down, there's free text, there's multi-text, like keywords. And then some of these are kind of subtle. This one here, description, is actually a language alternative. If you pop open the settings, you can see how we do this over in the view editor. You can build yourself a panel. This is mostly our default that comes with it, so you can kind of see how they're done. And we'll pick the description just to kind of peek at it. You can see that we're telling it it's a text, but you've got all of these other types of properties that you can choose from. You have to tell it what's going to be in the interface, what's the prefix and the namespace you're targeting, and then what's the property you're going to be reading and writing from. The text field happens to have some advanced properties like language alternative. So we turned it on here for description. Bridge doesn't show anything other than the default, but you can add other languages in here. You can just click a bunch and then add them in, and you want them to show up in the interface. I'm not going to make these changes right now, but know that you can. And then, of course, once you're done, you can save this change and it will show up in your panel when you restart the panel. You can also export to JSON, which is important because if I have a JSON file that came from my administrator, I can drop it here onto the settings and it will now, instead of referring to a local metadata view, it will refer to a remote one that sits on a server perhaps, and the whole work group can work together. Click over to Photoshop. You can see we're in Photoshop. This also applies inside of Illustrator, so I can crack open Illustrator and see the same panel inside of Illustrator. We hope you enjoy it. It's free in the marketplace. Please download it today.